Okay. Today, inshallah, we will talk about structure and we will review in some example what we have studied in our last lecture. Learn how to declare and use structure, passing structure function, and use array of structure. Here is our example. It is easy one, but we have solve this example in three ways, as you can see here. Our example is to compute the area of rectangle. Using width and height length. So all of you know that the area of rectangle is width by length. We create rectangle structure. If you remember, this safe word is used to create the structure. We have the name of the structure here, and we have the members of this structure. This structure contains three members, double, width of type double, and height of type double, and also area. So this structure contains three. Now here, we have used three ways, just in order to review what you have studied in the previous lectures and to know how to pass structure or pass structure member here. And here we are passing the structure by reference. So in the first one here, we are passing structure members. Can we pass structure members? Yes. And just like variables. And as you can see here, we call these variables by, we pass this variable by value. And in this way, we just pass the whole structure as we have talked about in our previous lecture. That we can pass the whole structure here like this, R, the whole structure, struct, and as you can see here, it is called by value. Okay, this is why I have defined the function here of type rectangle. It is the type of the structure here. Why I have written this? I have done that because I have that structure and I need to modify some value for this struct and return it back again. So this is the return type. The return type for this function is struct, and the struct is rectangle. We will show you how, inshallah. Finally, here, the third way of computing the width of the rectangle, the area or the rectangle area is to use a structure. But here, in order to make, to yani, show you the three ways, we have passed the structure by reference. So here we have passed the whole structure and we call it by reference. We call it by reference here. This is our objective of this example. Now we will go through the answer. So we need to apply these three ways for calling, for passing the structure member, for passing the structure by value, and passing the structure by reference. As you can see here, I have passed the structure by reference. So any changes inside this function will be directly reflected or done on the main program. So this is why I did not use here rectangle, that the return type is of type void. Why? Because all of the changes will be all of the changes done by the rectangle by done on this structure will be directly reflected on the main program. So no need to return the whole struct again. So this is why I have here defined it. This is why we have put here void. The return type for this function is void. Now, if we did not specify the way, you will solve it the way you like in the exam. If we did not how to define, if we did not write how to define a function, it is your choice to use the function you like and write the code the way you like. But if we specify the function that you need to use, you need to follow the function definition that we asked you to use. Okay, so we have here proposed three function definition, and we want you to use all of them inside your program. Look at the code now. I will clear the drawing and go to the code. Here is the answer key. I will review it to page one. One page, it's written. So here is the answer, as you can see. Here we have defined structure, our structure. And as you know, because we have mentioned this, this structure will be accessed by many functions. And this is why we have put this structure in the global area. Is it supposed to be always in the global area? No. But because here in our example, we are using the structure in more than one function, we have defined our structure in the global area here above all the function. Okay, you can use it inside function, you can use it and it's up to you. But here in our example, we are using this structure, or let's say this in other words, this structure is used in all the functions and can be accessed in all the functions. Here is our example, the main. We will start with the main here. We enter the height. And the way 5 multiplied by 10, which is 50. Okay, now I have called this function here, r.area to self compute area E, height, phi, width. So here I have passed the member of the struct. Member of the structure, I have passed the head for the height and the width. So we will pass 5 and 10. Just to tell you that we can pass the member of the function. It's just like variable. And these member are passed by value. Now compute area E will go here. We will have 5, and here we will have 10. There is suppose H to be here and W to which to be here, but because it is a multiplication process, this does not make any difference, because here height is supposed to be, height is here and here is width, so W is supposed to be here, but because it is a multiplication process, you can substitute them. And 5 by 10 is the same as 10 by 5. Then we have both this value and calculate the area. Then we have returned the area. As you can see here, the type of this function is double. So we have returned double. The area will be returned here to the structure. This is our first way to compute the area. The second way here, is to send the structure which is R. How we know that R is a structure, it is defined here. Right? We have passed the whole structure by value. I have here modify my structure. I said R dot area equal R dot height multiply by R dot width. But as you can see here, we have passed the structure by value. So changes will not be reflected here on the main program. So this is why we have write return, and we have defined the function of type, the return type of type struct. اللي هو rectangle هنا, أيوه rectangle. The type of function is rectangle. Then we have return our structure here. Here to this one. Okay. As you see, you can have it of type structure and type structure, so they should be of the same type. Okay. Last way, as you can see, we have used the function void. The return type for this function is void. This is why we did not assign it to anything here. But in order to reflect our changes in the main program, we have called the structure by reference. So here we have written compute area R, هذا R. We send this variable here by reference. Why we have done this? Because we did not want this function to return any value. And we want our changes to be reflected on the main program. So here I have modified the record or the structure R, and I call it by reference. As you can see here, the ampersand. Then I have multiply R dot height multiply by R dot width, and I have save the value here inside the array. So any modification inside the function will be directly reflected على R هذا and call by reference. After that, I have printed C out R dot array. So in the three function here, we are computing the area, but we have used more than way in order to tell you that we can pass the structure, the whole structure by value, and we can pass the whole structure by reference, and also we can pass the member of this structure, the member of this structure as variable. And of course, we can pass all the structure and the member of the structure by value or by reference, as you can see here. So all of them are correct. And if we specify in the exam the way we want you to create the structure, you should follow this way. But if we did not specify the way, it is up to you how to solve this. This task. Okay, guys, I hope it's clear. If this is clear, do you have any questions about this? Question, guys, do you have any questions? Okay, I hope everything is clear to you. Now I will go to next task. I will clear the drawing. Don't forget, this is in order to reflect our changes, we have used ampersand, and this is why we have written here void. No need to return anything because the value will be directly reflected here. Okay. Now I will go to next task. add to fraction here. We mean by fraction, شباب, اللي هو الكسر اللي في الرياضيات في الماث. اللي هو الكسر. الآن يعني هذا الفراكشن اللي هو الكسر. We need to add two fraction يعني نضيف كسرين. كسر، الكسر الكل بيعرفوا اللي هو فيه هو بسط اللي هو numerator and denominator في n and d اللي هو الوسط والمقام. اوكي. And we want to find the sum. نجمع كسرين. اوكي. ونطلع مجموع. طيب كيف نجمع الكسر؟ بكل بساطة القاعدة كان المستخدمة كالتالي. It is يعني it's supposed to write here the formula for you because we don't teach you math now. Okay, not the objective for me is not to teach you math, but here in the task they did not mention the formula, so I will try to explain it to you. For example, I have half. I want to add half to quarter like this. بدي أجمع. I want to add these together, these two fractions, and find the sum of these two fractions. لاحظ هذا مثلا نسميه N1 numerator 1 هذا D1 هذا N2 وتغيرت هذه D2 البسط والمقام. كيف بنجمع؟ القاعدة بتقول لك the rules is to say multiply N1 مع D2 then multiply N2 sorry D2 مع N2. يعني N1 مع D2 هي 1 في 4 اللي هي هنا طبعا كلها ضرب multiplication 1 by 4 which is 4 2 by 2 which is 4 اجمعهم then find the sum 1 by 4 is 4 2 by 2 is 4 then multiply 2 by 4 يعني D1 مع D2 المقام الأول مع مقام الثاني 2 by 4 which is 8 النتيجة هي عبارة عن 8 على 8 طبعا بالنهاية هي عبارة عن 1 1 يعني فعلا 2 quarter half plus 2 quarter فعلا هي 1 هي 1 because 1 plus half plus half equal 1 Okay, so this is the way that we will find the sum. We will take this denominator, this numerator, we will multiply it with the denominator of the second fraction, and we will take the denominator of the first one and multiply it with the numerator of the second one. Then we will find the numerator and denominator. We can divide them by each other. And find the result here. Now, the first number. Now we have here to pass fraction one and the fraction two. So fraction one, اللي هو رقم واحد الكسر الأول. Fraction two هو الكسر الثاني. This contains two value n و d. And this also contains two value n and d. In the example here, they ask you to define structure. Struct, fract. This struct is a fraction and it contains numerator and denominator. Then we have found the sum. Here we are passing fract. So as you can see here, this is the fract. In the function that we have to use, we should call two or pass two struct. two structures or two structs, two. The first one contains the numerator and denominator for the first fraction, and the second one here contains the numerator and denominator of the second fraction. Okay. فعندك يعني بنمر الرقمين ولكن every number كل رقم هو كسر والكسر بيحتوي على قيمتين يعني البسط والمقام. Okay. So this is how we ask you to solve this. You need to use structure. This structure. So for each, so each number or each fraction will be saved inside a struct. Let's go, inshallah, to the solution now. This also something like this. It is how it, this is how this task is solved. Now we have structure here, fract, int num, denominator, denominator, and this is our function. Here is our code. Here is the structure, and here is the function. As you can see here, it is I multiply the numerator of the first fraction with the denominator. يعني عملت هذه العملية كذا. بعدين then I have multiply the denominator مع denominator ل second fraction كذا. I did a multiplication process هنا N1 هنا D1 هنا N2 here is the two. هاي f1 لاحظ هذا الفانكشن باخذ two structure f1 and f2. Now I have multiply f1 في f1 dot num ضرب f2 dot dim denominator plus f2 dot num multiply by f1 dot denominator. اوكي نومينيتر اند دومينيتر هذه هي العمليه. طيب خزنتها في البسط للستركتشر وخزنت قيمه العددين هذا في هذا دومينيتر 1 في دومينيتر 2 في المقام اللي هو دي يعني كده عشان نشرحها مره ثانيه اتاكد for that everyone is with us. عملنا كده 1 في 4 4 2 في 2 اللي هي 4 وضربنا 2 في 8 الآن 4 في النتيجة 4 زائد هذه 2 في 4 وهذه 4 زائد 4 اللي هي 2 في 2 1 في 4 multiplication هذه النتيجة اللي هي 4 بلس 4 تخزنت في النيومينيتر هنا والدومينيتر we have saved inside it f2 denominator multiply by f1 denominator اللي هي 2 في 4 هذه يعني اللي هي كم 8 فهذا صار فيه 8 وهذا صار فيه 8 بحسب القيم اللي احنا دخلنا لو فرضنا انه احنا هنا دخلنا يعني 1.2 هنا دخلنا 2.4 اوكي يعني ربعين ونص هي واحد. So here I have defined x هذا for x for fraction 1. This is for fraction 2. I have entered the numerator and denominator for fraction 1. Then I have entered the denominator and numerator for fraction 2. Then I have called this function. Fract يساوي z sum x and y. Here I have passed the structure, the whole structure. The whole struct. The whole struct by value. Okay. كقيمة. And also I have returned it to a struct called define it. Which is set here. So I have passed x, y as structure here. هنا راح يروح ال x وهنا راح يروح ال y. مع القيم في الممبر اللي احنا دخلناها، يعني واحد واثنين راح تروح مع الاكس، 2 and 4 will go or will be passed with y. اوكي، وبعدها عملنا العملية الحسابية هذه وعملنا retain structure. هنا I have modified r.num and r.denominator. Then I have retained r. r راح ترجع مباشرة على الزد، وبرضه في ماتش في النوع. هذه r هي عبارة عن fract struct هيها، والزد هي عبارة عن fract، يعني في ماتش في التايب. وبعدها طبعت z.num divide by z.demo here. I did not divide them actually, but I have written them like this 8 by 8. As we have mentioned here, 1 before 2, 1 multiplied by 4 and 2 multiplied by 2, 4 by 4, which is 8. And for denominator, we have multiplied these two denominators here, and then we have printed the value here using set. Here I did not call the structure by reference. I call it by value. So this is why I did some modification on the denominator and numerator. So I need to return the value back again to the main program. So this is why I have defined my function of type is structure here, and I have retained the structure here. This is the code. Look, take a look at this code. Do you have any question, guys, about this? Is this clear? Are you with me? Or you are not. معي شباب انتو؟ والله شكرا. معي يا شباب؟ اتأكد بس. يعني فور شات. اوكي. سيان يوسف سلاش حسن فوزي محمد. تمام. Great. Thank you. Thank you. Now, يعني last question or last task. We have talked about this, يعني we have solved this type of task, but today we are going يعني to use structure. Structure. Okay. إذا بتتذكروا, if you remember this task, maybe in week number 3 or 4, we have here Sarah. هذه سارة اللي بتوجد الشورتست باث اللي هو S1. سوبر ماركت، سوبر ماركت 2، سوبر ماركت 3. هذا S1، هذا S2، and here we have S3. And every entity here have name، له اسم، هذا ال entity وله موقع position. نفس الشيء، every سوبر ماركت له اسم وموقع. N name position B. بس الشيء هذا has name and position. Okay. هذا له name و position. اسم و موقع. So we have a structure here of type entity. راح يكون عندنا structure في entity. في name وفي الموقع اللي هو position. النيم هو string والposition هو b. طيب هذا أول فكرة هنا من هذا البرنامج. كل entity، كل كائن له name، has a name and has position. والposition زي ما قلنا هو long latitude واللاتيتيود، أيهم اللاتيتيود واللونجتيتيود أو x و y. لا، والبوزيشن هو عبارة برضو another structure في له latitude واللونج latitude واللونجتيتيود. اوكي، هذا هو. هذا البوزيشن. طيب فلاحظ انه here the idea of doing this is to show you how we are calling this structure inside this one. الانتيتي، الانتيتي في نيم وبوزيشن. طب البوزيشن هو بي، البي عبارة عن ايش؟ عبارة عن latitude and longitude. latitude and longitude. وهذه الفورمولا معروفة لكم، لإيجاد أقصر طريق shortest path. وعندنا برضو function، إذا في عندنا function هنا to find the distance. إذا تتذكروا يحسب البعد، واحد كمان another واحد to eval the distance اللي هو رجع أقصر واحد the closest one. Then we have call distance اللي هو راح يحسب المسافة بين سارة وهذا، سارة وهذا، سارة وهذا، بحسب المسافات. والإيفال ديستانس another function بيحسب لي أقل مسافة ورجع لي أقصر مسافة shortest طيب اذا we have here two struct. struct في الانتيتي وفي النيم والبوزيشن، والبوزيشن it is another struct here has two values longitude latitude. now الفانكشن اللي راح تحسب الديستانس بين النقطة ونقطة، في كل فانكشن راح نحسب فيه الديستانس هذا، اوكي راح نبعث له two struct، راح نبعث له structure سارة وواحد من هذول، بنطلع المسافة وبدنا نعمل كول مرة ثانية. We'll send again سارة structure معلومات سارة، ونبعث مين؟ معلومات S2. وبعدين في الكول الثالث نبعث برضو سارة ونبعث معلومات S3. نحسب ال distance، calculate the distance based on this formula. وafter find the shortest path. هذا no change on this function. It is the same function that you have studied before. اللي هو الايفال ديستنس، حساب اقرب نقطه، او شو يعني احنا بنطلع الديستنس then we will find shortest path. الان خلينا نشوف الكود. I will clear. don't forget we have entity we have position. ولما نحسب الديستنس نبعث تو ستراكشر، تاع ساره وتاع اس 1، بعدين تاع ساره تاع اس 2، then we call again ساره اس 3. after finding the distance we will evaluate the shortest one by using eval distance. look at the code please now. طبعا don't forget also before I go to the code just I want to remind you انه لازم نستخدم راند. هنا في السؤال مش مستخدم الاسراند، اي بريفير انه تضيفوها عشان يعمل لك فليكر، يعني تصير المواقع تتغير في كل راند. but the idea هو we are not focusing in this task about on the function, we are focusing on the structure. but you can add اسراند in your code here, you can add اسراند in your code here. Now let's go to the task now or to the solution. Here we have some hints. بقول لك structure entity هذا واحد، وعندنا البوزيشن B. لاحظ هذا nested structure. نست structure البوزيشن، والبوزيشن هنا بي هي تحتوي على هذا latitude الآن، والبي تحتوي على مين؟ longitude. it contains both and we have used rand. okay I prefer to use also srand عشان يتغير معك في every run، واستخدم معها time srand with time. اسراند فليكر اذا تتذكروا، هذا بيعمل فليكرينج اور اكتيفيتنج للفانكشن تو ميك ذا فاليو تشينج ريجاردينج. سو الاسراند تشينج according to a value. So we need to add here, if you remember, a value that change frequently or change a lot. So here we have added the time in Isran, and we have include the C time. I think C time, include C time, if you want to do that. In our example here, Isran is not used, so you can use it. But as I have mentioned, we are not focusing on using function. We are focusing on passing the structure. Now here is our code. First note here, هذا الأول اللي هو position and هذا entity. And يعني please note that we have defined the position before عشان نقدر يتعرف عليه. بس إذا حطيت struct هنا يعني عكستهم أعطيك compilation error إذا عكستهم. هذا position you are going to use this position here. So it is supposed to be defined before here. Okay, if you have swapped them together, a compilation error will show up to you. You have to define the first structure here, and the structure, yani the structure that you are going to use here should be defined before. So here we have struct position, latitude and longitude, and we have the entity one. Entity one, it is the structure that we are going to pass to calculate the distance. As I have mentioned, we have to pass two structures, Sara and this one. This is our first call. In the second call, we will pass also Sara and this two. And in the third call, you are going to pass Sara and S3. Now here, this is our function to calculate the distance. Okay, there is something here wrong. I will ask you about this later, but here is our formula. It is not wrong, but there is something extra. We have here add something that is unneeded. غير محتاجين يعني we don't need to do يعني we need to remove some piece of code because it is not necessary. Here is the formula, square to power, you know this, and return the value. Now we'll call distance هنا, receive two structure, location one, location two. We mean by location one, Sara location. It is of type entity structure, okay? And also we have passed here entity two, it is the supermarket location. Then we have find the different distance between the two, these two points using their structure. So if as you can see here, we have used location dot v dot longitude minus location two here of identity dot v dot latitude. شوف هذه عبارة عن location. Look one, look two. Location, location, entity, entity. We have written here location one, location one. Here, dot entity, location one of type entity dot b. شوفوا كيف بتعامل مع nested. ما بكتب dot position. I will write dot b. Here, dot b. Dot member. فدائما the last word will be the member name. Last word بتكون هي الممبر نيم الحقيقي يعني الموجود هنا. Here is the variable location one هي dot b هي dot long attitude minus location two dot b dot long attitude to the power two plus power location dot b dot long attitude minus b dot latitude. Okay, I have subtract them, then I found the power, then I have find the square thing. This is our first function, and here we just evaluate the distance. We have passed D1, L1, L2, L3, and we have compared if L1 less than L2 and L1 is less than L3, then return 1. So here we are returning value of type integer. we will retain one is the nearest, and we will retain two if L2 is the nearest, and we will retain three if L3 is the nearest or supermarket number. No change on this function and no new ideas here. We have but we only pass doubles and return integer. Okay, now I will go to the main program. I will try to minimize something here. No. كده أنا I have initialized my structure. أول إشي زي ما أنتوا شايفين سارة it's one and we have it's two it's three the same with the same يعني thing. As I mentioned we did not use srand. I prefer to use srand with time and include it in the header file here and include the library c time here and use srand. And maybe you need to use CSTDLib. Now, here we have Sarah. خلصناها في الاسم. هاي Sarah. هاي عنا اللي هو entity. Entity صار فيها منه three instance. Sarah. S1. And we have S2. And we have S3. هنا في S1 حطينا سارة الاسم سارة وعرفنا random number للposition تاعها يعني هون راح يكون name وال خلينا نسميها الجي مثلا والA هون راح يكون اسم والجي والA و the same for here and the same for here. Now here let's go down to the code. Here the same I have initialize or set some value to S1, S2, S3, and Sarah. And every time I'm passing the structure, Sarah, هذا, مع واحد من هذول, بحسب الdistance. يعني, first of all, I will pass Sarah with S1, then I will pass Sarah with S2, then I will pass Sarah with S3. Here, بما أنتم شايفين هنا I have sent call distance Sarah مع S1 Sarah مع S2 Sarah with S3 طيب بعثت structure في call distance حسبته هنا أوكي بعثت الS Sarah على location 1 والS1 على location 2 وحسبت النتيجة ورجعت النتيجة هنا D1 D2 D3 Then after that I have evaluated the distance هنا Okay Then I have mentioned as you can see if closest this one then اطبع S1.name يعني اسم أقرب سوبر ماركت if the closest is 2 هاي هنا اتحرك كذا شوي كمل if closest is 2 راح اطبع s2.name يعني اسم ثاني سوبر ماركت if the closest one is 3 I will print s3.name it's the closest one okay so this is the logic but here I wonder شباب يعني انا شايف I don't know I want you to answer this if you can يعني هذا اللوجيك للفونكشن هنا. I think there is something wrong. I don't talk about compilation error. Now here في هذا الفونكشن في شيء معين هنا كذا يعني no need to add. What do you think في هذا الفونكشن؟ في شيء معين شو هنا؟ Yes. Yes.
Pass by reference.
Pass by reference. Who's with me?
Yusuf.
Yes. No need to pass by reference. صح. إحنا هل إحنا هنا بنعدل شيء في اللوكيشن؟
لا.
ما بنعدل. Great. Great, Yusuf. Thank you. No need to pass it by reference. يعني. هو مش خطأ، ما راح أعطيك error، ولكن no need إنه نعمل link because we are not modifying any value. ما بدنا we don't need any value to be returned للمين بروجرام. We just calculate some value. We don't do any updates. So need no need. أي راح أكتبها هنا no need to call by reference. Excellent. Thank you. To call by reference. No need. Okay. يعني مش شايفين في حاجة إلى. هل أنت بتعدل بتعدل location dot b أو location dot b dot long latitude أو location two dot b dot latitude? No modification. You just calculate some value. So why we have to call it by reference? No need to call it like this. خلاص call it by value. No need. هي مش خطأ ولكن no need. This is the first task. Now here we have passed زي ما انتم شايفين عملنا passing the structure, the whole structure by reference by value. Also we have passed structure members. Okay. وبرضه عملنا استخدمنا nested structure. Nested structure زي اللي هو as we have said here, we have explained اللي هو الانتيتي مع البوزيشن. البوزيشن وحكينا if you have done something like this لازم هذا الستركتشر يكون معرف فوق عشان الكومبايلر في الديب سي بلس بلس بيتحرك من فوق لتحت. And it's supposed to be defined before. Anything should be defined before. آخر شيء راح نتكلم عنه طبعاً ما له حل هذا لأنه حله طويل وهو جزء من مشروعكم بيشبه مشاريع يعني راح أو بعض أفكار المشاريع اللي راح تشتغلوا عليها اللي هو array. الآن راح نتكلم عنه array of structure. راح أفتح ملف الأسئلة وأرجيكم إياه array of structure. Array of structure. آخر شيء. إذا إحنا عملنا pass the struct, pass the structure by value, pass the structure by reference, passing the structure members, passing the or using nested, let's say using nested structure, and finally we are going to talk about array of structure. خلينا نروح على المثال clear drawing now. I will just stop sharing this and share the اللي هو lab question. هذا ال updates why we have removed this because first of all it is too long. Second of all, we have يعني talked about. We will talk about how to use array of struct in array of struct in. راح تشوفوها في file في file part two. Part. Okay. Now write a C++ program to keep records. And performed statistical analysis for a class of 20 students. The information for each student contains, as you can see here, student ID. We mean by ID number, name, sex, quizzes, scores. We have two quizzes, midterms score, final score, and total score. Total score. إذا إحنا عنا بدنا we have 20 students. كل student في له هذه المعلومات. فأنا بحاجة لعشرين طالب. هذه هي فكرة مشاريعكم اللي حاب يشتغل على يعني array of structure و saving array داخل file وأخذ يعني كمشروع database قريب على بشبه مشاريع database taking these value from array of struct, saving it to the file, update the value, saving it again to the file, delete some value, and save the latest changes to inside the file. So here we need, we have this structure, student, and as we have mentioned here, we have date. How you date? اللي هو date of birth هنا. Well, of type date. We have date month. الآن هنا, I need to define array of struct. أنه أنا بدي أتعامل مع 20 طالب. يعني هنا we have to use something like, write something like this. Student. تخيلها integer أو double. هاي اسم الأري std. عددها كم؟ عددها 20. يعني هذه array of structure. It is not array of integer. It is not array of double. It is array of struct. Now, we need to define a function for add. طيب, a function for delete. Function for update. For review. Calculate the total score. Show student who gets the maximum total score. Show student who gets the minimum total score. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7 function. وهذا يفضل في المين بروجرام يكون عبارة عن أرقام choice. First of all, if you have selected one, you will add a student. If you have selected you do, you will delete. 3 for update, 4 for showing all the student, 5 for calculating. Here the total. It's not the average. المفروض هنا تكون the total. يعني هنا اوكي تخزن القيم هنا total وبعدين we will find the maximum and the minimum total. All of these are separated functions. This is what I want to see in your project. If you have used array of struct or you have used files or you have implemented a game or whatever, you need to يعني use function. Okay, use function. Don't write the whole code without function. We need to يعني see that you have learned a new thing and you are using the concept that you have learned in this course. Now here, نفس الفكرة, the same idea. تروح على الاد اللي درسوه في الاد داخل الاري. طيب, الفكرة انه احنا عندنا مثلا بمسك ال std of number of element إذا بتتذكروا, ولكن بدل ما أضيف قيمة بحط اثنين, بضيف فيها قيمة معينة بقرأها, بقرأ cn name هذا الأد وبضيفه داخل الأري ال n. هذه number of element, بعدها بمسك ال std of n number of element ل for example date of birth dot dbo dot day. Okay, then std and the dbo dot month الى اخره dot year. Then بسخ دخل ال quiz 1 quiz 2 assignment midterm final. Okay, دخل هذه المعلومات. هذا الاد, يعني هي نفس فكره الاد, the same idea of the adding process that you have said previously, but you need to access the members. The members, فهنا راح يكون عندي كذا, كان اتخيلها, you need to imagine انه في عندنا array of record. يعني هنا كل في name, في كل element في name, في quiz 1, في quiz 2, في mid, في final, and we will find the total here. هذا الآد. طبعا لما أنت تضيف بتزيد ال number of element هذا n plus plus. هذا هو الآد. Now any delete process and update process first of all need search. بدك تعمل, طيب بدك تعمل search by what? By search by ID, it's up to you. Any delete or updates a process need search a process first. This is why we did not add here, but myself I prefer to add a function for the search. يعني يكون عندي search هنا. Okay. However, in the update and delete function, you will do a search process. Okay. Now here there is a delete. خلينا نتكلم على الابديت. الابديت هي عادية. مثلاً الابديت by number. راح أنت تقول له في الابديت function cn number. وراح تعمل for loop في السيرش. For loop, then you will write here std of n dot number equal الرقم اللي انت قرأته, وراح تعمل update للريكورد سواء النيم تضيف فيه قيمة الكويز Q1 Q2 Q3. So it is not that different from the update that you have learned, but you have to access the member here. And تقول له std of, for example, i. وفرضنا انك لقيته في ال i هنا. Dot name, std of i dot q1, std of i dot q2, and so on. هذا ال update. It deletes the same. Delete function, نفس الشيء. راح يسألك راح يسأل عن بدك تحذف by ID مثلا delete by ID. It is a function. بطلب منك ال ID. دخل ال ID هنا. تعمل for زي ما ذكرنا هنا بsearch. For search by ID. For if. وإذا ماش نفس ال delete process. شو بتعمل؟ بتعمل shift لكل ال الاليمنت. يعني اذا في عندي فرضنا انه هذا هو اللي انا لقيته هنا, this is the item that I want to delete, then I will shift. طيب راح تقول لي يا استاذ طب الشيفت هو عادي, شيفت مثل الاري العاديه؟ نعم, لانه اذا تتذكر احنا في المحاضره قلنا لك انه S1 ممكن تتخزن في S2, هذا ستراكشر وهذا ستراكشر, وهذا ستراكشر ممكن اسحبه كامل احطه مكان هذا, هذا اسحبه مكان هذا. So it is an you are dealing in the delete process with elements of the array. You are shifting the whole element. STD of 1 or STD of 2 or STD of 3. So هنا STD of 2 راح يروح مكان 1 and STD of 3 راح يروح مكان 2, will be shifted to 2. هذا الديليت. فيو هي فور للطبعة, يعني الفانكشن الثالث اللي هو فيو راح امسح. فيو اللي هي للطباعة. فور لوب. اوكي للطباعة. تعمل فور لوب بس بدل ما تطبع الاليمنتس فور اي من الاليمنت اللي هو std of i, we will write std of i dot name, std of i dot 6, std of i dot dbo dot t, std of i dot dbo dot year, std of i dot dbo dot month, std of i dot quiz 1, quiz 2, assignment, midterm, final. هذا الديسيبلين اللي فيه فور لوب هو. طيب وعرض, ولكن انت لازم عشان تطبع البيانات لازم توصل له في كل اليمنت. يعني راح تقول له std of i for example dot اطبع لي dot name, std of i dot quiz 1, quiz 2, quiz 3 الى اخره. الاخير الان او هذا اللي هو الكالكوليت. هون قلنا بلاش average, هو total. total calculate total. شو يعني هذا بيعمل؟ تعمل function بتمرر له انت الـ elements. تعمل function كذا بتمرر له هذه الـ elements للـ array. وهذا الـ function بأخذ الـ elements هذه وبطلع الـ total. يعني بمسك الـ record هذا مع هذا مع هذا مع هذا مع هذا وبجمعهم وبحطهم هنا. بجمعهم بحطهم هنا. اوكي طبعا زي ما اتفقنا we have array of structure, يعني std of 20 من نوع student, يعني too long to يعني you need to write a lot of يعني many lines of code. After calculating the total لكل واحد بصير عندك هنا التوتال مخزن، برضه بتعمل لك فور لوب بتطلع الماكسيمم فانكشن للماكسيمم وبتمرر الاري وبتطلع المينيمم. ناو اول ذا فانكشن، اول ذا فانكشن اللي انت بدك تعملها هنا انت راح تمرر لها الاري اوف ريكورد، يعني راح تمرر لها اري اوف ريكورد، لهذا راح يجي اري اوف ريكورد يعني الاري كامل اللي هي الاس تي دي. هذا ارجع refer back to the slides to see how we are passing array of record, and here we are passing array of record and so on. So here we are passing array of record, array of record, array of record. Yeah. Now because I am passing the whole array, معروفة هذه طبعا, أي change في الأري بنعكس will be directly reflected على المين بروجرام, لأنه as we have mentioned passing the array is much like passing by reference. But we don't write ampersand. Don't forget this. I have talked about that, and I am repeating this now to make sure that you understand what I'm talking about here. We will pass the array by array of struct to this function. So any change في array inside this function will be directly reflected على main program. Okay, now the قضية هي you have to imagine what is happening. You have the array element. Now inside the array element you have member. You need to access. لازم تتخيل شو اللي بصير. طبعا this is will help you inshallah in يعني in upcoming courses. And will help you how يعني to access this element, because in other courses everything is about objects. يعني في الجافا 1 أو 2 we have object and every object has properties like the structure. This is somehow similar to class, نوعا ما بيشبه الكلاس, ولكن في الobject oriented programming جافا في feature أكثر, فيها feature أكثر وأقوى من C++. However, هذه الأوبجكت أنت بتعملها. You are dealing here with objects. هذه الفكرة. Okay, شباب. I know, يعني code is too long. يعني we will talk about this إن شاء الله in as I have mentioned in file part 2. راح تشوفوا real example في add وفي delete وفي search وفي save وload. Okay. لا array of structure, array of structure. في update, search, delete, add, view, إلى آخر. So this is why we move the here the solution, and because also we want you to start your project.